Good evening. A gang of reckless teenagers has broken into a Langwarrin mosque, riding around on bicycles and smashing windows and displays. Community leaders say they're deeply hurt by the show of disrespect, but are willing to forgive the intruders. Here's Penelope Leash.
Teenagers hoon on stolen bikes in a sacred place reserved for prayer.
The praying area is a place where you don't even take your shoes. That was really painful.
Treating the carpet like an athletics track, the vandals form a line and race across the room. They'd swiped the bicycles from storage after breaking into the House of Peace Mosque at Langwarrin. The intruders jumped two security fences to get inside, kicking over witches' hats before one of them starts bowing in mock prayer.
For people to come in and do this, it was definitely hurtful.
Within minutes, a dozen offenders smashed a ladder through a window, destroyed displays of holy books, tore up a badminton court and broke into an office. The noise woke Iman Wadud Janood around 2 a.m. He lives downstairs with his wife and two children. He was on the phone to police as he tried to scare off the vandals.
First thing I would find was the hockey stick came out and I banged it on the fence loudly a couple of times and I actually saw them, you know, run out of the building.
Thousands of people are part of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community. The centre was meant to host a program of children's activities today.
A mosque is a place of communion for all people.
It's not the first time the mosque has been targeted. There have been other incidents of vandalism and threats in the past. But the damage of this break-in will have a lasting impact.
Most of members of our community, they've escaped persecution from different parts of the world. And they gathered here so that they could live their life, you know, peacefully and worship the faith that they want to worship.
It makes them scared. They never expect this to happen, especially considering that, you know, we do events here where we invite members of the public.
Forensic officers have spent the morning collecting evidence, but leaders at the mosque are already willing to forgive those who caused the damage.
I will be more than happy to show them around, ask, you know, answer any questions or concerns that they may have.
Come in, sit with us. Lunch or coffee will be on us.
Penelope Leash, Nine News.